Hello friends, welcome again. This is we are doing power transmission. I am continuing power transmission. Today I am taking up gear drive. This is another mode of power transmission using gears. You know, gears are defined as toothed wheels. Gears are wheels having teeth which mesh with each other and transmit power from one shaft to another shaft. Now this is the best drive when the distance between the two shafts is smaller. The disadvantage here is we cannot manufacture very big gear wheels. It is not possible to make. So when the center distance between the two shafts is very large, we cannot use gear drive, which is a positive drive, and there is no slip, you get constant. There are many advantages in this. There are so many advantages compared to other drives. This is highly advantageous, most efficient drive. Anyway, now how they are classified? They can be classified on different basis. On the basis of the position of the axis of the driver and driven shaft, they are divided into spur gears, bevel gears, skew gears, etc. Like this they are divided. And they are also classified on the basis of the material used, metallic and non-metallic gears. Then on the basis of speed, they are classified into high speed, medium speed, low speed gears. High speed, medium speed, low speed gears. They can also be classified on the basis of the curve that is used for the teeth. They can be classified into involute gears and cycloidal gears. Generally, these are the two curves, involute and cycloid. These two curves are used for the shape of the teeth. So they are called involute gears and cycloidal gears. Like this, on different basis, they can be classified into different types. Now, what we have is, generally we study this. This is the one which is important for us, that is spur gears. Now these gears are used to transmit power between two shafts whose axes are parallel to each other. When the axes of the two shafts are parallel to each other, they can be connected by means of spur gears. In spur gears also there are different types, helical gears. This rack and pinion is also a spur gear. You have a number of different types. Now we have to know some terms here which are used in gears, that is called as spur gear terminology. Spur gear terminology means some definitions that are used in spur gears. We use some definitions. These definitions you are supposed to know, that can be asked in theory. Like there are a few of them: addendum circle, Dedendum circle, pitch circle, addendum, dedendum, width of tooth, width of space, backlash, then you have circular pitch, module pitch or module, diametral pitch, then you have working depth, hole depth, clearance, etc., etc. These you can get it from other videos by animated this thing. You can get it in other videos available on the YouTube. For mathematical treatment, this is important. This, then these three: module, diametral pitch, and circular pitch. These are very, very important from numerical point of view. So I will be taking up this. Now, pitch circle first. Pitch circle is an imaginary circle. It is defined as an imaginary circle. The definition of pitch circle is like this. Pitch circle is an imaginary circle passing through the pitch centers of the pitch cylinders from which the tooth profile is generated. That is how it is defined. This is the pitch circle. Its diameter is denoted by D. D is the diameter pitch circle dia. Whenever it is, the gear wheel is specified by its pitch circle diameter. That means whenever we say the gear dia is, the wheel dia is 50 mm, 60 mm, 80 mm, whatever it is, we are telling the pitch circle dia and not any other circle dia. It is the pitch circle dia which is given in this as the specification of the gear wheel. So this is one important point to be noted. Whenever we say dia of the gear is so much, it is the pitch circle diameter. And next, for correct meshing of two gear wheels, the pitch circles, this is let us say this is one wheel and this is the pitch circle of one wheel, the wheel, and the other wheel is like this. So this is the pitch circle of the other wheel. Now these two should be touching circles. This, there should not be any gap there. It should not be like this. This is wrong. It should not cut also like this. It should not be like this also. It should not be like this also. This is the correct meshing of two gear wheels. Now here, when two circles touch each other, there is a property, there is a theorem which you have studied in 10th standard in school, that says when two circles touch each other, then the centers of these two circles and the point of contact, they are in a straight line. This property of the touching circles will be utilized here. So this is the correct meshing of two gear wheels. I have been giving it in a very short manner so that we can do some problems. Then after pitch circle, the next one is circular pitch. The next definition, important definition, is circular pitch of the gear wheel. It is given as PC. Now this is similar to pitch of a screw thread. Pitch of a screw thread, it is the distance between two similar points on consecutive teeth measured parallel to the pitch circle. The distance between similar points on successive teeth of a gear wheel measured parallel to the pitch circle, that is called as circular pitch. Mathematically, pitch circle, the circular pitch will be equal to pi d, that is circumference of this pitch circle, divided by t. Here d is dia of pitch circle, and t is number of teeth on the gear wheel, number of teeth on the wheel. PC is equal to pi d by t. You must remember this formula. Then next is module pitch. It is called module or module pitch. It is denoted by M. This will be, M will be equal to D by T. It's the ratio of pitch circle dia 2, number of teeth on the gear wheel is known as module. Then you have diametral pitch. Diametral pitch is the reciprocal of, it is denoted by PD. It is the reciprocal of module, that is, it will be T by D, that is number of teeth on the gear wheel, number of teeth on the wheel to the pitch circle diameter. This ratio is called as the diametral pitch. Now, when two gear wheels are meshing with each other, they may have different D, they may have different T, but they should have same circular pitch, same module and same diametral pitch. When two gear wheels are to mesh with each other, their circular pitch, diametral pitch and module pitch should be same. That is one. And then in any gear wheel, the product of these two, PC into PD, will be equal to pi, because DD will get cancelled, TT will get cancelled, PC into PD will be pi. Then this into that, module into diametral pitch, will be equal to 1. This you must remember, in any gear wheel, this relationship is there between them. And you must know that all the three pitches, diametral pitch, circular pitch and module pitch, should be same when two gear wheels are to mesh with each other. So with this, if you have this much knowledge, then we can do the problems. We can do numericals on gear wheel. The problem will come like this. There is only one problem in the question bank given on gears. I have taken that, and then let us see if we can do one more problem. Problem number 16 in your question bank. I have taken this. This is the only problem on gears which is given. Two parallel shafts 600 mm apart are to be connected by spur gears. One shaft runs at 360 rpm and the other runs at 120 rpm. Develop the gears if the circular pitch is 25 mm. So he has given the central distance between the shafts. It is 600 mm. This is approximate. He says this can be slightly varied. That can be varied. What he wants is one wheel should rotate at 360 rpm. This is the condition. And the other should rotate at 120 rpm. Now the smaller wheel, smaller of the two wheels, will have the bigger speed, higher speed. So this is the smaller wheel and this is the bigger wheel. When we connect two shafts by means of gear wheels, one will be smaller, one will be bigger. The smaller one will rotate at a higher speed and the smaller wheel is called the pinion. So I will call this as NP and this as NG. The smaller one is called as the pinion and the bigger one is called as the gear. The bigger one, out of two wheels, one is bigger and the other one is smaller. The bigger wheel is called as the gear and the smaller wheel is called as the pinion. Speed of pinion is always more than the speed of the gear. Now, this can be given like this. They have given separately this RPM, or they can say the velocity required, velocity ratio is 1:3. That means if this rotates one revolution, this will rotate three revolutions. Like that also they can give the velocity ratio. Then what he has given is, he has given circular pitch, that is 25 mm. Now what we have to find out, develop the gear wheels means, we have to find out DG, what should be the dia of the gear wheel, DP, diameter of the pitch circle dia of the pinion, NG, that is number of teeth on the gear, that is bigger wheel, number of teeth on the pinion, and also the exact center distance. These are the things to be found out. Now, I told you that these two circles will be touching circles. So if they are touching circles, this center distance must be equal to dg by 2 plus dp by 2. That is dg by 2, that means this radius, plus dp by 2, or I can write it as dg plus dp divided by 2 is equal to c. So dg by plus dp is equal to 2c, that is 2 into 600, that is 1200 mm. dp plus dg, or dg plus dp must be equal to 1200 mm. dg plus dp divided by 2 is always the center distance, so its dp plus dg should be about 1200 mm. Then we also know that dg ng is equal to dp np, so dg will be equal to dp into np by ng, that means np is 360 and this is 120, so it will be 3dp. dg must be, the diameter of the gear must be 3 times the diameter of the pinion, then only they will rotate at a speed of 1:3. So now what I do is, I have two unknowns, I don't know both dg and dp. I also I got two relationships. One is dg plus dp is 1200 mm, and dg is equal to 3dp. Now what I do, I substitute dp plus, instead of this dg, I can write it as 3dp, that is equal to 1200 mm. So dp, this becomes 4dp. dp means this is 1dp, understood? So 1dp plus 3dp will be 4dp, will be 1200 mm. So dp will be equal to 1200 divided by 4, that is 300 mm. Approximately it will be 300 mm. Now after this I get dg also. Dp is 300, this is 300 mm dia, so this will be 3 times that. Dg will be 3 times dp, that means 3 into 300, so 900 mm. Approximately it should be 900 mm. Right, now we should not decide it now itself. Next what I will do is, I have to find out these two, ng and np. They have given pc, both the wheels will have same pc. You know pc is equal to pi dg divided by ng, tg. Pi dg divided by tg. So tg will be equal to pi into dg is 900 divided by PC, that is 25, this is 25. If I take this TG here, this PC will come here. So pi into 900 divided by 25, pi into 900, this works out how much? This works out to, let us see how much it works out to, pi into 900 divided by 25, this works out to 113.09 teeth. Comes like that. Next, I will find out, similarly, TP will be equal to, TP will be equal to pi DP divided by PC, because PC is also equal to this. Pi into 300 divided by 25. Let us see what I get. This will be pi into 300 divided by 25. Now this will be 37.699 teeth. Now you know that the number of teeth cannot be fractional. It cannot be, the gear wheels cannot have fractional number of teeth like this. So what we have to do now is, we have to adopt two values which are whole numbers. which are whole numbers as close to this as possible, and they should be in the ratio 1:3, because we want one wheel to rotate at 3 times the speed of the other wheel, so they should be in the ratio like that. Now the values that I can choose is, first what I will do is I will take TP, this is the value I got, very close to this I will take, say 38 teeth I can take. I should take either 38 or I should take 37. I am taking, because this is more than 5, more than 0.5, I am taking 38 teeth. Then TG will be equal to 3 times TP. The number of teeth must be 3 times that. So 3 into 38, that will be 114 teeth, 114 teeth. So now it is fixed. This is fixed. The number of teeth are fixed. So now what I have to do is, after fixing the number of teeth, I have to find out, again go back to here, and now find out, as per this, if the number of teeth are this much, what is the diameters of the two wheels? That is, I have to find out DG and DP. DG will be equal to, from this equation, DG will be equal to PC into TG divided by pi. So PC is 25, TG is 114 divided by pi. Now that gives me 25 into 114 divided by pi. That gives me 907.2 mm. This is the exact diameter of this wheel. This is called the gear, and this is the pinion. So it is 907.2 mm. Now similarly DP I have to calculate. DP will be equal to PC into TP divided by pi. So 25 into number of teeth is, we have fixed it as 38, divided by pi. So 25 into 38 divided by pi will give me roughly 302.4 mm. So these are the exact diameters. Now again what you have to do is exact center distance is to be found out between the two shafts. Center distance between the two shafts, this C will be equal to DG plus DP divided by 2. That is, DG value I have got now 907.2 plus this I have got as 302.4 whole thing divided by 2. 907.2 plus 302.4. The total of these two is 1209.6 divided by 2. That is, it will be 600.4.8. This will be close to this given distance, but it will not be exactly the same. It can either be little more or it may be little less. If you have taken TP as 37, this would have come 111, then you would have got it little less than 600 mm. Now I am getting it as 604, little more than 600 mm. So this is how the problem on gear wheel is to be done. There are no further problems given in the question bank. So that was the only problem that is given. So what I will do is, from my memory, I will take one problem from a paper of 1985. He had given like this: the two parallel shafts about or nearly 300 mm apart. That is, central distance is nearly 300 mm apart, are to be connected by spur gearing. The desired velocity ratio is 11:3. If the module of the gear wheels is 6 mm, find the number of teeth on the wheels and the exact center distance. So this is how it is given. A problem will be given like this. They will give the approximate center distance will be given, velocity ratio will be given, or the two RPMs will be given, and either module or diametral pitch or circular pitch, any one of these three pitches will be given, and they will ask you to find out the number of teeth on the two wheels and the exact center distance. Here this problem is slightly odd because this velocity ratio is little odd. Now we will draw a rough sketch. This is the one wheel and this is another wheel. Now this is the pinion, this is the gear. When this makes three revolutions, when the bigger wheel makes three revolutions, the smaller wheel should make 11 revolutions. That is the meaning of telling the velocity ratio required is 11:3. Now the distance between the two, this distance should be approximately, this is given as 300. So again we will use the same formula here, dg plus dp divided by 2. Always this will be equal to the center distance. The center distance will be equal to half of dg plus half of dp, or dg plus dp divided by 2. So dg plus dp is 2c, that is 2 into 300, that is approximately 600 mm. They should be approximately 600 mm apart. Next, dg by dp always should be np by ng. So this is 11:3. When pinion makes 11 rotations, the gear makes 3 rotations. So dg is equal to 11:3 dp. So I got two relationships here. Dg plus dp is this much and dg is equal to this much in terms of dp. Now what I will do, I will substitute for dg in terms of dp. So it will be 11:3 dp plus dp is equal to 600 mm approximately. So you have to take LCM here, 11 dp plus 3 dp. If you take LCM here, 3 dp is equal to 600. So 11 plus 3 is 14 dp by 3 is equal to 600 mm. So dp will be equal to 600 into 3 divided by 11. That works out to 600 into 3, sorry, 600 into 3 divided by 14. This is 600 into 3 divided by 14. It works out to roughly 128.6 mm. This works out to 128.6 mm approximately. Now dg will be equal to 11:3 into dp, that is 11 into 128.6 divided by 3. This is there with me, into 11 divided by 3. That gives me 471.4 mm approximately. 4 mm. So I got approximate value. They will give the center distance, they will give the velocity ratio. From these two equations, we have to get the diameters of the pinion and the gear wheel approximately. Then after that they have given module. They will give one of those module pitch or circular pitch or diameter pitch. Here module pitch is given. If module pitch is given, they both should have same module. So we know M is equal to DG by TG. So therefore TG will be equal to DG divided by M. TG will be equal to DG divided by M. DG we have got as 471.4 divided by M is given as 6 mm. So 471.4 divided by 6. This gives me 78.57 and TP similarly will be equal to DP divided by M, that is 128.6 divided by 6. 128.6 divided by 6, that will be 21.43 something teeth approximately. Again here you will get like this, a fractional number of teeth. We cannot have fractional number of teeth. Now the teeth, the number of teeth on the gear wheels must be whole numbers, and also we know TG is to TP. TG is to TP must be equal to 11:3. Then only you will get a velocity ratio of 11:3. So TG is to TP must be equal to 11:3. Now what we have to do is, as close to these numbers as possible, we have to select two numbers, which are two whole numbers which are in the ratio 11:3. Now the possible values are, these are the possible values, 66 and 18. See, 6 11s are 66, 6 3s are 18. The next possible values are 77 and 21. 7 11s are 7 3s. The next available, the next possible value is 88 and 24. 8 11s are 88, 8 3s are 24. So these are the values that are the whole numbers very close to that, which will give you this ratio of 11:3. Now the nearest among this, the closest possible one is this one. This one. So what you have to write is, you have to write, therefore we are adopting adopt TGS 77 teeth and TPS 21 teeth. I took this problem because this is a little odd ratio. Right, TG and TP. Next, what you will do, you will use this value of TP and TG and find out the exact value of DP and DG. DP will be equal to M into TG, TP, and DG will be equal to M into TG. 6 mm. This should be the dia of the pinion, and this will be 6 in 462 mm. Now exact center distance. Now it is DP, DG plus DP divided by 2, that is 4 is 462 294 mm. This will be very close to 300, but it will